Hello, this is the video for the presentation of example 4 of VC Tools, which demonstrates the interface of VC Tools with CA Engineer when dealing with unreinforced masonry buildings in their design and in their assessment. First of all, we'll go through the layout of the building under consideration. It is a two-story unreinforced masonry building which has in the ground floor stone masonry of 40 centimeters thickness walls, as we see here, with doors and window openings, and also has a reinforced concrete slab over this ground floor. This concrete slab is 13 centimeters. In the first floor we have brick masonry of only 20 centimeters thickness, which also has a 13 centimeter reinforced concrete slab over it. First of all, we will model the building within CA Engineer. We see here the building as it has been modeled according to its geometry, using wall elements for all the pier, for all the piers, wall 80 elements, using cell elements for all the spandrels, lintels, etc. We see that there are cell 98 elements for all spandrels and lintels, and we have thus accurately modeled the whole building. The slabs have been modeled with plate elements as in normal reinforced concrete buildings. Since CA currently does not have masonry as a material, we are using a modified concrete material, as we will see now. We have modeled the stone masonry using a concrete material, inserting its actual unit mass, its actual modulus of elasticity, and also a characteristic compressive strength, while we use only two other tabs of this menu, meaning the FZK005, the lower and upper 5 percentile, which would have been used for concrete, in order to include the shear information of the unreinforced masonry. The shear strength information of unreinforced masonry is FVK0, FVK0, and FVK0. These two information are inputted in these two cells. When EC Tools runs the analysis, it recognizes from the compressive strength that this is a masonry material and it treats these values accordingly. The same applies for the brick of the second floor, where we see we have a much less unit mass because we don't have solid bricks, we have hollow bricks, and we have different shear FVK0 and FVK-lim values. Apart from that, all the other parameters are the same as in a normal analysis. We have the self-weight, the additional dead, the live, the seismic in the X direction, seismic in the Y direction, and also the equivalent static EX stat and EY stat, which is a self-weight in the X and the Y direction correspondingly. After we perform the calculation, we go to, for elastic and model analysis, we go to plugins, EC Tools, and we save the XML information of the model as example 4 XML. After saving this information, we close the model, not before we save all the information, all the changes we have already made to our model. After we close the model in CA, we open EC Tools, Start menu, Programs, EC Tools, or we open the corresponding ETP file, which is the EC Tools project file, which has already the information saved within it. The information is that we have the general options as in the previous examples, we have the design options where we have a Q0 override of 2 because it's an unreinforced masonry building. We have all the checks activated, although most of them are not applicable, for example, the capacity design for masonry buildings. And we also have this specific area where we define the safety factors for masonry and also the ratio of the tensile to the compressive strength of masonry when dealing for several parts of the analysis. After we have done these selections, we start our design assessment of this unreinforced masonry building. We have all the sections of the masonry piers as they have been prepared by Easy Tools. We can see all those piers, and their names corresponding to the model can be seen through the DXF that has been created during the analysis of during the design, which is example 4 DXF. Which can be viewed, it can be shaded and viewed in 3D in any AutoCAD application. We see, for example, the names of all the piers that have been described. Currently, Easy Tools does not deal with spandrels. So, we proceed with the analysis. Where we see that in story 2 there are masonry piers which are not adequate. These masonry piers, as we did in the previous examples of assessment and retrofitting, can be inserted a jacket. When inserting the jacket, the safety factor increases. We save this pier 11 at story 2, and the next time we run the analysis, this will be blue.